who face a test of their musical knowledge in Pop Quiz.
Welcome to another edition of Pop Quiz. You're lucky you missed the audience singing out of tune at the beginning there. Tonight's givers are from The Who, John Entwistle, from Dozy, Beaky, Mick and Titch, Dave D. First of all, let's meet John's team, and here he comes from the Monkees. Will you please stand up, Davy Jones?
I am standing up.
Oh, you are standing up, sorry. X Undertone and Assemblyman Fergal Sharkey. And their skipper from the legendary Who, John Entwistle. And on the opposing side, playing kneesies with me under the table from Bucks Fizz, Cheryl Baker. And from Big Country, Tony Butler. And the man with a whip keeping them in order, Dave D. Individual round to start with, and I'm going to play each of you an intro from a well-known song. All you have to do is tell me what the song is. Easy, eh? Davy, you're first to go. Here comes your intro.
There's the Beatles, obviously. Baby, You Can Drive My Car.
Baby, You Can Drive My Car, yes, well done. Thank you. 2 points. Cheryl, your turn. Here comes your intro. Currently in the chart.
It's in the chart. It's Sons and Daughters.
Sorry?
Is it? What is it?
What is it? Pass them what it is.
Hot water. Is that what you say?
I mean, is that... How do you say in an individual round, is that what you say?
No, I heard the right song. Level 42. Yeah. I was right.
Level 42 and hot water. Heaven knows why I'm giving you the 2 points. But 2 points, yes, because you knew what you were on about, really. Right, Captain John, for you, another intro.
Wonderful Land, Shadow.
Wonderful Land by the Shadow. No problem at all. Straight in there. Like a good skipper, scoring 2 points straight off. Dave D, let's see if you can do the same with this one.
That's it.
A confident nod.
Nick Kershaw, her Human Racing.
Human Racing, Nick Kershaw. Another 2 points, Fergal. Few bars coming up for you. A smile means either you're pleased with the suit you've just bought or you know the answer.
Well, about the suit, it's Bronski Beat, and believe it or not, I can't remember the damn title.
Oh, you can if you think.
What is it, Downtown Boy?
Close.
Boy, something. Go on, give it to me. Go on.
I will give it to you. It's Small Town Boy.
Small Town Boy, yeah.
Small Town Boy, Bronski Beat. I'm being so generous in this round. Tony, for you, another intro.
Sounds like Adamant to me.
It is Adamant. Currently in the charts with...
Apollo 9.
Apollo 9, Tony. Yes. So, at the end of round one, Dave D's team 6, John Entwistle's team 6. Right, we've got a team round coming up, so pens and papers out. You can confer. We've edited together 10 songs on the theme of water. I want you to list the artists only. Okay, the artists only. You don't need to list the songs. Theme of water, and here we go.
Stab a sorry heart with your favorite finger, paint the whole world blue, and stop your tears from stinging.
When I was a little girl, I had a bread gun, only
What's the matter with me? I don't have much to say.
Looking, so he's done 10 rounds with meatloaf. Right, John Entwistle, how did your team get on?
About 9.
You think about 9?
Yeah.
You got 9?
John is not quite as confident as
don't
you
worry
are.
About
Dave, how many do you think you have? They think no, they have somewhere between 6 and 9.
We've got, I think we've got 7 definites and 1 dodgy one.
7 definites, a dodgy one.
Dodgy one.
Do you want to try with your 6 or possible 9 first?
Yeah. Kim Wilde.
I'll tell you afterwards.
Echo and the Bunnymen, Ike and Tina Turner, Simon and Garfunkel, Bruce Springsteen, Talking
Heads. Right, I'll tell you how many you've got in a moment, Dave.
You want me to read them out to you?
Mm-hmm.
Right, Kim Wilde, the Bunnymen, Tina Turner, Simon and Garfunkel, Bruce Springsteen, CCS, Tap Turns on the Water, I think that was. Question mark. That doesn't qualify.
It might have been Dylan or someone.
Yellow, have you got Dylan? Was it?
I put that down because it sounded like it could have been in. You know when
no,
you
no, Yellow River, we can't remember the name of the band.
Dawn?
No, it wasn't Dawn.
Australian band, wasn't it?
I can tell you that. Yeah, do I get a point for telling you that the Tremolos actually played on that record?
Yeah, I did know that actually.
Yes. Do I get a point for that?
They produced it.
And I still can't remember the name of the band.
And Deep Purple.
I'll tell you how many you've got in a moment. Firstly, it was Kim Wilde, Water on Glass, Echo and the Bunnymen, Seven Seas, which you both call Ike and Tina Turner, River Deep, Mountain High, Simon and Garfunkel, Bridge Over Troubled Water, The River, Bruce Springsteen, CCS, Tap Turns on the Water. It was Bob Dylan, Watching the River Flow, you were quite right. Yellow River, despite the fact that Tremolos played on it, it was Christie. Talking Heads, Take Me to the River, Deep Purple, Smoke on the Water. So 6 to John Entwistle's team and 8 to Dave D's team. Score at the end of round 2 to John Entwistle's team 12, Dave D's team 14. On to round 3, which is the lyric round. 2 rounds coming up on your screens of a famous lyric. Also, I'll tend to read them appallingly to you. Cheryl, you're first to go, and yours is Neon on my naked skin, passing silhouettes of strange illuminated mannequin. I can never write stuff like that.
I can't think.
It's in the charts, and it's this one.
Neon on my naked skin, passing silhouettes of strange illuminated mannequin.
Alphaville and Big in Japan. Always tough, the sort of current ones. Davey, can you tell me which song these lyrics are taken from? See her gentle sway, a wave out on the ocean, could never move that way.
I can't think. I like the lyrics, but...
Well, we'll just be watching
I'll give it a
you.
Nine.
We'll be watching you grimacing on the screen as you listen to this.
See her gentle sway, a wave out on the ocean, could never move that way.
Tick, 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 tick. Johnny
Tillotson.
And nice. Poetry in Motion.
My favourite, the first record I ever bought.
Really?
Yeah.
Nothing there. Dave, have a look at these lines. Something told me it was over when I saw you and her talk. Something told me it was over when I saw you and her talking.
Yes. It's,
When I saw you and her cheating, in this case.
No, she's...
He didn't look.
Well,
she could
actually,
be wrong.
I know the name of the band, and now you've given me the title. It was Chicken Shack, and it was I'd Rather Go Blind.
It's very difficult to know what to do when you're right, but you've cheated. What I'm going to do... Why? Because you half knew it. I'll give you 1 point out of 2. It was Chicken Shack, and I'd Rather Go Blind. Because you did know the
cheating?
Sorry?
Do I get a point for cheating?
Point for cheating. Cheeky of it, honestly. So 1 point there. Well done, Dave. John, have a look at these two lines. Well, they just don't know what's going to replace it, yeah. Ballads and calypsos, they've got nothing on real country music that just drives along.
Cliff Richard, move it.
Cliff Richard, move it. No trouble, despite the bad way I read it. Tony, here's your lyric. You say your love is bona fide, but that don't coincide with the things that you do.
I honestly don't know.
I didn't put you off then, did I,
Bob? You did, terribly. Phil Collins?
No. So close. Nick Lowe.
You say your love is fortified, but that don't coincide with the things that you do.
Nick Lowe and Cruel to Be Kind. Both Nick Lowe and Phil Collins sitting at home thinking, what do you mean so close? So close. Right, Fergal, your last go. See if you can tell me where these lines come from. And all the world is football-shaped. It's just for me to kick in space. And I can see, hear, smell, touch, taste.
It definitely wasn't me. And outside that, I don't know.
I won't say close because it's XTC.
And all the world is football-shaped. It's just for me to kick in space, and I can see his smell touch taste.
And sense is working overtime. right, we have John Entwistle's team with 14, Dave D just ahead with 15.
Serious.
Real needle match here. Another team round coming up. We're going to show each team three clips. I'd like to know the three artists, the three songs, and they were all hits in the same year. John, your team first to go. The three artists, the three hits, and the year they were all hits, please. The artists and the songs.
A T-Rex.
Yeah, we've got them all. We've got them all right.
It's just getting the right order, aren't we? T-Rex.
Oh. The centre one. I don't know.
What was the song, T-Rex?
Last one was Slade.
Still Love You.
Last one. Do you know this title?
I Still Love You. Was that the title of that?
Close.
T-Rex.
Yeah. It was a variation of that of some sort of Love You.
Because I Love You.
Because I Love You, yeah. Okay. I'll buy that. But didn't Mark Bowen look good?
Right, so you got the first one, T-Rex, Mark Boland. Do you know the song?
Get It On.
Get it on, right, okay. And the middle one?
No idea.
Any idea at all? The middle one was Curtis Mayfield and Move On Up Toward Your Destination. Do you know the year that they were all hits, all the same year?
So that wasn't first? A wild guess at 74.
The answer is 71, so I can give you 2 out of 5. Two out of five. Dave, here comes your three clips.
This time. All the clubs are being closed down. This place is crawling like a ghost town. Bands won't play no more. Too much fighting on the dance floor. Don't you want me? You know I can't believe it. You know I don't believe you.
We're confident.
That yes. confident you're going to tell me?
Yes.
Okay. You just sort of keep it to yourself?
Well, yeah, we were getting off on it, actually. Right, the first one, Ghost Town, Specials.
Mm-hmm.
Second one was Human League, Don't You Want Me.
Mm-hmm.
And the third one was Tainted Love, Soft Cell, and we reckon that was 1981.
Absolutely right. 5 points. Well done. Still, anything can happen yet, you know. That's the end of round four. John Entwistle's team, 16. Dave D, 4 points in the lead with 20. Right, an individual round. An individual round coming up, so not too much conferring. Davey, your first go for you, a clip of Billy Joel.
Well, I'm living here in Allentown, and it's hard to keep a good mind at home. But I won't be getting up today.
David, Billy Joel singing Allentown. Can you tell me, for 1 point, which album that came from?
The name of the album.
The name of the album, that particular song.
Right. I like the album very much. It's a good album, that one, yes. I didn't recognize him too much without his piano there.
Yeah.
I left my piano in San Francisco. No?
No, nylon curtain.
I'm sorry, guys.
Okay, for another point, or in your case, for the first point, can you tell me his first UK top 20 hit?
Yeah.
Great.
Again, Just the Way You Are.
Just the Way You Are.
Just the Way You Are.
You say such wonderful things. 1 point out of two for you, Davey. Cheryl for you, some Daryl Hall and John Oates. Right, One on One appears on two Hall & Oates albums. Can you name one of them?
Two albums. Yeah. Would one be their greatest hits that's just been released?
Oh, that's a real cheat. No.
Do you mean two proper name
two
ones?
Two proper name ones, yes.
One Private Eyes?
No, one of the others.
Oh.
No, the answer is Rock & Soul or H2O.
Oh, H2O.
And for 1 point, can you name me which instruments, or tell me which instruments Daryl Hall plays?
Oh, he plays keyboards and guitar.
Keyboards and guitar, yes, 1 point. Well done. Right, John, over to you. See if you can pick up a couple of points on this. For you, a clip of Family.
Just for 1 second, one glance upon your dome. Flower of my childhood could appear within this room. Treasure of my youth, tears of yesterday. Broken hearts within a heart. Change of our first son. Happiness of family made a brother for the one. Growing up the brothers, manliness the doom. Is it there in detail? Is it there the view?
It always reminded me of a singing Bob Harris. Can you tell me the lead singer of the group?
Roger Chapman.
Roger Chapman is right. Can you name one of the groups you left Family to go and form? Anyone will do.
Streetwalkers.
Streetwalkers, yeah. Chapman Whitney Streetwalkers shortlist, or just Roger Chapman as Roger Chapman. So you have 2 points. Well done. Right, Cap and Dave for you. A clip of Culture Club playing live on the Church of the Poison Mind. Today, for 1 point, can you name the guitarist and the bass player with Culture Club?
Roy Hay guitar and Mickey Craig bass.
Mikey Craig, yes, and bass. Hello, George is in. So, for another point, can you name the film which Boy George has recently written songs for?
Oh.
Current film. Fergal is bzzing, but he's not allowed to bzz because it's your turn.
Oh, dear. You're not allowed to help me, are you?
I don't know it.
Quite a few singles out from it at the moment. Electric Dreams is the answer.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Hoo hoo. Fergal, for you some for you some Iggy Pop.
I got a hard ass pair of shoulders. I got a love you can't imagine. Yeah, and what I got a double. I swear I'm keeping out of trouble. I'm looking for one new value. Looking for one value, nothing comes my way.
One point, what had he taken just before the performance?
Whatever it was, I'd like a pint of it, please.
Actually, in 1977, David Bowie played keyboards on his US and UK tours, that's on Iggy Pop's tours, and also on Iggy's album of that year. Do you know what the album was called?
Lust for Life?
It wasn't.
Ah, there's one before that. Though.
Well, it was called The Idiot.
Oh, God, yes, fine, thank you.
It's a terrible answer to give you.
Fine.
For 1 point, can you name his backing band?
Which... After
Iggy Pop's
or before he
band.
Left the Stooges.
Yeah, his well-known backing
band. The Stooges.
The Stooges, yes. For one
Thank
point,
you.
Well done. Finally, in round five, Tony, it's your turn for you. A clip of Joe Cocker.
Here we attack out for an aeroplane. I've got to spend. I'm gonna find my way back home again. Oh, the lonely days ago, I'm coming home. Yeah, I'm in a snow building. Well, after all,
no wonder he's got a sore throat. The great Joe Cocker. Tony, I'll give you a bonus point if you can do a quick impersonation of Joe Cocker.
Definitely not good enough. All right, I can do that very well.
That was Little Richard doing Joe Cocker. Right, for 1 point, who first had a hit with that song?
The Box Tops.
The Box Tops did, for 1 point. Well done. For another point, can you name the double live album Cocker made at the end of his US tour with Delaney and Bonnie and Rita Coolidge, people like that?
Yeah, I don't think I'd like to make another album again. No, I don't.
You don't? Mad Dogs and Englishmen. Yeah. Was, which I'm sure you knew. With 1 point Russell. Out of two. Huh?
With Leon Russell.
And Leon Russell as well. Another quite point. Right, yes. Right, now you've got the bonus point for the impersonation. Anybody want a quick point over here for your side? You do need the point. Anybody a quick impersonation of Joe Cocker for the point?
I've got to make a ticket for an airplane. Can't have a fast train.
Yes, yes,
I need a car.
I think a bonus point for Davy Jones for that over-the-top impersonation of Joe Cocker. So, at the end of round five, John Entwistle's team 21, Dave D's team 24. Round six is the round where we show you a pop legend. Captains put their fingers on the buzzers, and as soon as you think you've identified the pop legend and also the track running backwards during the video, which is more linked to what you see in the video than the person themselves, as soon as you've identified the person and the backwards running track, captains press the buzzers. Here we go. Well, nobody's pressed yet. Any lights coming on, Dave or John? Yes, John buses first. It's a team round, yes. That's the case.
We think it's Wheels of Industry. It's a track.
You think it's crushed by the wheels of industry?
Yes.
And who do you think the person is?
Idiot was leaping around in that boiler suit. It could have been me in disguise and I wouldn't have known. Let's say Captain Sensible for the hell of it.
Okay, right, you say that. Let's see whether both your answers are correct. Fergal, you're right.
And a silly person like you is silly enough to do that.
I like it. At the end of that round, 24 to Dave D's team, 25 to John Entwistle's team.
This is what we need.
Right, quickfire round. Who recorded a country album called Almost Blue? Almost Blue.
Elvis Fergal. Costello.
Elvis Costello, 2 points, who is on next week's show. Who wrote and had a hit with Blue Suede Shoes? 3-1 for Fergal.
Elvis Presley, yeah.
And no. Who wrote and had a hit? 1 point to somebody else. Who wrote and had a
Carl
hit?
Brown.
John, Carl yes, Perkins. Carl Perkins is right for 1 point. Who told the story of the blues in 82?
Elton
Tony.
John.
Huh?
Elton John.
No, Story of the Blues in 82, Fergal.
Mighty Wah.
The Mighty Wah for 1 point. Whose hits included How Can I Be Sure, Daydreamer, and I Write the Songs? Cheryl.
Is it the Partridge Family or David, what's his
David
name?
Cassidy.
David Cassidy. Right. Cassidy.
He said it and I was going to say it.
I'll give you one point each.
One
it's
point
all
each.
Friendly
yeah,
here. One point each, David Cassidy. Who wrote I Write the Songs? Yes, Cheryl.
David Cassidy.
No, he didn't. 1 point to somebody else, Davy.
One of the Beach Boys.
You're right, but which one?
Come on, David, you know where it is.
Yeah, come on, David.
Was he? Mike Love.
No, Bruce Johnson. After all that, Roddy Frame is the leader of which group? Tony.
Aztec Camera.
Aztec Camera, 2 points. Who's this?
You're gonna find me out in the country.
Yes, John Emerson.
It was you.
It's not Cliff Richard. And 1 point to somebody else. Anybody else?
Oh,
the answer. The answer is the Farmer's Boys.
Oh.
Who first had a hit with it? Yes, Fergal.
Cliff Richard.
Cliff Richard in the Shadows, yes. The right answer to the wrong question, John. Which early 70s group contained both Robert Palmer and Elky Brooks? Yes, Cheryl.
Was it?
Vinegar Jug.
Yes, that's right. Whose first number one was called You Can't Hurry Love? Dave.
Supremes?
It was not the Supremes. 1 point to somebody else, Tony.
Phil Collins.
It was Phil Collins. Yeah, the Supremes had already had number one before that. Who got to number 10 in 78 with Hurry Up Harry? Fergal.
Oh, Lord.
No. Come on. Oh, come on. No. Time wasting there. So 2 points to
Sham 69.
Sham 69. Yes, if you don't give an answer, 2 points to somebody else. Which four-piece supergroup made their debut at Woodstock in 69? Yes, John.
Crosby, Stills, Nash.
Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young. Yes, that's right. Which band did David Crosby work with before that? John.
Birds.
With the Birds, 2 points. David Bowie had a hit with Bing Crosby. What was it called?
White Christmas.
Yes, Davey.
White Christmas.
It wasn't. Nice sentiment, but not right. It
White
was Cheryl.
Peace on Earth.
Peace on Earth, yes, and Little Drummer Boy. 1 point to you. Whose hits include Bridget the Midget and a song on which he appeared as a group of chickens?
Ray Stevens.
Yes, Dave?
Ray Stevens.
Ray Stevens, you're absolutely right. And one bonus point if you can do an impression of a group of chickens. Over the top. That brings the final score, amazingly, to Dave D's team 36 and John Entwistle's team 36. Well, who would have thought it would have ended like that, eh? Let's say goodnight and thank you to both teams who've been great sports. And they are from Bucks Fears, the lady who used to write letters to Davy Jones, and tonight gets a chance to meet him, Cheryl Baker. And for a big country, a man who's never written to Davy Jones in his life, Tony Butler. And their skipper, who'd like to write to Davy Jones, Dave D. Who would like to say good evening to Dozy, Beaky, Mick and Titch as well. And of course, who are in the audience, John Entwistle's side. Here he goes, walking down the street, Davy Jones. And a man who's never been in the Monkees, Fergal Sharkey. And their skipper from The Who, the Ox, John Entwistle. Well, as money changes hands and the showers are turned on, we'll see you next week for another pop quiz. Phil Collins and Midge skippering the teams. Phil Collins, Elvis Costello and Huey Lewis against Midge John Martin and Nick Lowe. We leave you tonight with Elkie Brooks and Robert Palmer when they were in Vinegar Joe at the Royal College of Art in 1972 singing Everybody's Talking. From a lively crowd here, good night. We'll see you next week.